DjTira's wife and socialite Gugu Kati is involved in a nasty fight with one of her neighbors that has turned into violence. Gugu and her 50-year-old neighbor Cindy O'Neill have opened cases of assault against each other at Honeydew Police Station. This whole drama took place on Friday night at the upmarket Willowbrook Estate in Roomsech. This is where it said that both O'Neill and Kati family reside. Speaking on O'Neill's behalf, her husband Benjamin claimed that he was on the roof putting up Christmas decorations on Friday when Kati's son Junior drove past their house at a high speed. Benjamin said Gugu Kati came rushing to their house and giving them a warning, saying that it is their second warning. Benjamin said that he and his wife were confused about Gugu's outburst and O'Neill ordered her to leave their property. Gugu stepped back and tripped over the bicycle. We tried to help her up and she refused. So I went back to putting up the decorations and left them there. She got up after being helped up and she punched my wife once in her face, Benjamin recalls. When Gugu Kati was asked about the disputes, claims she refused all of them. Instead, she said that they attacked my son and then turned around and attacked me. Junior's little brother came rushing and told me, "Come see what these people did." I rushed to their house to ask what my son did to deserve this, and they looked at me with an attitude. The woman Cindy came at me. She pushed me so hard from the garage into the street where the bicycle was. I landed on it. I literally can't walk right now, Gugu said. She did confirm that she punched O'Neill. Kati said she was also speaking on behalf of Junior, her son. I was trying to show her that I was injured and she kept dragging my feet. She couldn't let go. As soon as I could kneel, I punched her so she can get off me. In other words, Gugu is saying when she punched the woman, the elderly, she was defending herself. So Cindy's husband, Benjamin, had said that it is not the first time that Gugu Kati has outburst violently on them. Benjamin carried on to say that sometime in January this year, when Gugu Kati hosted a birthday party, they had a nasty exchange of words when the party was noisy after 11 p.m. He claimed that police had to hold her back so that she don't attack him physically. He carried on to say that they not seeing wrong in their ways. They don't understand that you cannot speed and drive recklessly when there are kids around. They need to realize that you live in a communal estate and you must respect others. Benjamin said that on a Saturday, Junior and his friends followed him around in a car, even tailgating him. He captured the moment in a video clip that has been seen by Soweto Live, excuse me. So Benjamin claims. On this, the Kati responded by saying that the O'Neills are the ones following Junior for the last 3 years and they have lived there, and she even tried to get a protection order but was not successful in the courts. She carried on by saying, "They are crazy. They have called us everything, including criminals, because we are always changing cars. They even harass my kids outside the estate, taking videos of him," meaning Junior. "We are always traveling and I'm afraid for my son's safety." It is alleged that Benjamin carried on to say that Kati is using her celebrity status to her advantage. He carried on to claim that on Tuesday, two policemen that were not working on the case came to arrest his wife, of which she was not there. And these policemen were accompanied by Junior. It is alleged that he carried on to say that our attorney then called the investigating officer and he was shocked as to who the cops were. So in my opinion, this seems to be getting nastier by the second, and that, you know, for her to punch an elderly like that, even if they are in the wrong, but then still, like, you just don't hit an older person. That is actually of your parents' age, you know. It doesn't matter what they did, you know. That walking away is the best thing to do sometimes on some issues, you know. Yes, they can be like exchange words and everything, but also even in doing so, there are some things like you don't say to an elder person. Even if they are wrong, you just walk away. And then if they have done you wrong, if you want to open a case, yes, open a case and involve the courts and everything, but then just don't hit back, you know. Honestly, even if they punch you in the face themselves, just don't hit back. Honestly, just some respect, Nyana, you know. I'm not saying she is, I mean, like the O'Neills were right or whatever, because I was not there. But just the fact that the older person is bruised, and there are photos to prove it, and her, she has nothing to prove. There's no photos to prove or whatever, unless like I didn't see nicely, or maybe I didn't do my investigation properly. But honestly, just some things you just don't do. Whenever there's any disagreement with some issues or some things like the neighbors don't like, you know, like if you live in a commune, like you just have to respect some rules. There are rules that need to be followed, you know. So, yeah. So comment down below and tell me what do you think about this whole thing. And yeah, it's just messy. So subscribe and hit the subscribe button if ever you have not yet subscribed. And yeah, see you on my next upload. I'm loving you. Ciao.